Back a long way to look at rivalries in Canadian football, one of the most intense. And if you watched on Monday afternoon, you'll believe why. The Argonauts and the Tiger Cats. The history is a long one.
Lake Ontario, it's one of the Great Lakes, and oddly enough, its shoreline, a few miles of shoreline, separates two cities involved in one of the greatest rivalries in the Canadian Football League, and maybe in pro sport for that matter. And it's a big rivalry now. It was certainly big in the late 60s and the early 70s. And joining me now, a couple of players that played in that era, Peter Martin, linebacker with the Toronto Argonauts, and Garney Henley, who played both receiver and defensive back with the Hamilton Tiger Cats. And Peter, starting with you, what did this rivalry mean to you in your playing career?
Well, as a Toronto Argonaut, it really meant the season. You could go and lose 14 games. If you played two against the Hamilton Tiger Cats, you had to win those two. There's no question, with the cities being as close as they were, interesting comparison between the two cities, Hogtown, Toronto, the big city, big bucks, Hamilton, the steel town, all kinds of comparisons, and it just seemed that your entire reputation was at stake every time you stepped on the field against the Tiger Cats.
Well, it is strange, too, because like Peter said, the two towns, although very different, yet still very close. The rivalry with the players, the rivalry with the fans was just outstanding. And I think the community got involved a lot more than they are at the present time. But it was a fun time. It was a hard-working period that I think we all went through, because most of us held jobs down and everything else, but other than playing football. So it was a good time, and it was fun to play Toronto, whether it was in the playoffs or whatever, because you're right, it was probably as big a rival as there is in North America.
Was it just geography contributing to this rivalry? I mean, was there something more to that?
Well, I think we were reminded anyway in Toronto that we all made too much money. I remember John Barrow coming over as our general manager, and the first meeting he had with the players, he says, after all those years in Hamilton, the reason you guys lose in Toronto is you make too much. So I guess we were the big bucks. We seemed to be the team that brought in all the superstars. The Argonauts every year would bring in a superstar. People in Toronto used to say that the Hamilton, they waited till the Argonauts made their cuts, and that's how they did their recruiting. So there were a lot of different things that sort of made it a go. The economies of the two cities, the lifestyle. But I think the key thing, though, was the fact they were only 45 miles apart in that Labor Day doubleheader. People would drive down to Hamilton on Saturday, drive back to Toronto on Monday, or vice versa. And that, to a lot of people, that was the highlight of the football season.
We looked at Toronto as the overpaid guys. You know, those guys are making a lot more money than we're making. And you know, here we're the ones that are winning most of the time. And it's not quite fair. So we just wanted to beat the hell out of them all the time. And that was part of the reasons. And you know, the fact that 45-minute drive was so easy for everybody to make, I think, just created that atmosphere that was such a great rivalry.
And that obviously worried some Argos. I heard a story about Leon McQuay. How did that go with you?
Well, the Tiger Cats like to try to intimidate, you know, with that black and gold and so on, and the way they dress with the stripes and so on, and the roar and so on. They tried to put the fear of God into everybody, and they like to play the intimidation game. They had the reputation of being the big tough guys with the Angelo Mascas and so on. And Leon McQuay, as Argonaut fans will remember, was an outstanding running back. But to be honest, Leon didn't really like to play against the Hamilton Tiger Cats, and the Tiger Cats knew that, and it was very obvious for everybody in the ballpark that their plan was, the first opportunity you get, you climb all over Leon's head, even if you have to take a penalty. And they would do that with great success, because Leon really didn't do anything against the Tiger Cats.
Yeah, I think really we had a lot of fun doing some of those things, and obviously you get to know each other because we play so often. We used to play exhibition games two or three times, and you'd end up playing the number of league games that you did, and the incident that you're talking about, Leon, obviously that's what we wanted to do. We felt that he was a little bit intimidated by playing with us, and the first opportunity we had, you know, we wanted 12 guys hitting him at the same time, and somehow we seemed to usually always be able to do that.
Did the adrenaline flow a little bit more maybe when you knew you were facing the Ticats or when you were facing the Argos?
No, no question. I mean, the coaches made a point of stressing that, and they didn't really have to, but they stressed the point, and it was always a tense moment for us coming over the Skyway Bridge and coming over the bridge into Hamilton, because you knew you'd better have your chin strap buckled up.
Yeah, absolutely. That's exactly why. I think the press certainly built this up and created the atmosphere that was there, obviously. That's right. When we love to get Toronto into Hamilton, because we just knew we were going to win, and we knew that we were going to just, it was going to be a war. no specific game sort of rings to me because we played so many games and there were so many good things happening. And I just enjoyed the competitiveness that we had with each other.
Garney Henley, Hamilton Tiger Cat fame, and Peter Martin, Toronto Argonaut fame, I thank you both. And I just want to point out one thing. I didn't want to show any bias here. This is a special shirt I had made with the blue stripe and with the black stripe, of course, for Hamilton and for Toronto. And of course, the black and blue represents all those bruises you guys have had over the years. Thanks very much for joining us.
Thank you.
One of the truly great rivalries in Canadian football, the Argonauts and the Tiger Cats. Some would have thought, Leaf, that maybe it was being overplayed until we watched those two teams play on Monday afternoon. They don't like each other at all.
No, John, they really don't. And I don't think the rivalry is ever overplayed. Of course, when I played in Hamilton, we always look forward to the Labor Day game as any other game against Toronto because we like beating the tar out of that team. And we did not like them. They don't like them. Now you saw, even though it was a blowout on Monday, they were fighting, scratching, and kicking and everything right till the very end. Cook got thrown out. So it is a great rivalry that will become more intense as the season